Right, this is NX2 coming at you, pre-recorded as always. Today I have our very own talent coordinator, who's very talented herself, Mariah Curtis.
Oh, thank you. Stop it, stop it.
speaking of one of those talents, one of the first things I actually wanted to ask you, because I've just been excited to ask, is you were once the co-host for the Wilkes-Barre Connect podcast. As someone clearly trying to figure out podcasting, I would love to know how you got started doing that.
Yeah, absolutely. So I started as an intern with the Greater Wyoming Valley Chamber of Commerce, I think is their new name. I apologize if I totally botched that, but at the time it was the Greater Wilkes-Barre Chamber of Commerce. But I started as an intern there. I think it was my second semester at Wilkes University. And then after my internship, I was involved with the Connect program. You know, once my internship was finished, I continued to go to the networking events and everything. And then they decided they were going to do a student ambassador program just to help, you know, raise awareness to students in the local colleges. So I ended up receiving an email from our COO, Joe Boylan, at the time. He was the director for Connect. And, you know, he said, we would love to have you back as a student ambassador. So, you know, there was this awesome group of students and we all got together one night at Think Center. And, you know, we were just talking about how we were going to get ready for this big conference that they were doing that November. And we just, like I said, we kind of shared ideas as to what we could do to raise awareness. And, you know, we had these awesome, like really great ideas. And one of my group's ideas was to start the podcast. So my co-host, Nick and Singa, shout out Nick, and I, we just kind of took it on our own accord and started, you know, planning, seeing who we could have on the podcast, and then literally just ran with it. We found like random emails on the company websites of who we wanted to get into contact with, or we utilized the chamber in their contact just to find out, you know, how do we get in touch with these people? And then pretty much just emailed them, hey, you know, I'm Mariah Curtis. I'm the student ambassador for the, you know, the Wilkes-Barre Connect program. And, you know, can you come on for an interview? We really want, you know, to highlight the young professionals, you know, the CEOs, the directors of companies within our area, as well as the students. And I was able to interview over 24, you know, individuals from Northeastern Pennsylvania, talk about their stories, you know, connect with them. And like I said, with the students as well, you know, why NEPA? Why did they choose to plant the roots here or start off and get their education here? So it was a great experience. I was so scared to interview people just because I never thought of myself as someone who could kind of do, I mean, podcasting, it is like kind of public speaking, but, and just being able
to, so it's a little bit different.
Yeah, exactly. So you're like in a stuffy room with people like real close together, you know, like you don't really know them. But yeah, that kind of really sparked my interest. And as you'll see in this interview, you'll realize I do like to talk as much as I might talk about how I'm like timid. But yeah. And then that kind of just sparked it, you know. And for myself, on a personal note, I do have like a passion project of mine that I want to start, you know, my own podcast and kind of just formulating how that'll go. But that's kind of how I started my journey and my venture in podcasting, was through Wilkes-Barre Connect.
Does the new kind of format of doing things through Zoom, or like how we're currently doing through Iris, does that like interest you at all? Or do you prefer the old way where you always had people coming in and doing it in like a studio environment?
I think it's definitely more accessible, easier to get people involved. So definitely, yeah, I think it's positive. It's, you gotta get your, you know, you gotta get pretty for the Zoom calls, but, or through Iris. But I do think it's definitely way easier. I mean, if you want to connect with people across, you know, the state or across the US or something, like it's just finding time to connect with that person, you know, and then getting that interview. And I like how it's like the kind of that personal touch too. You get to see people and, you know, the back and forth. I think it is definitely really awesome the way that podcasting has transformed.
Okay. I couldn't imagine trying to do that. Like, back then when you didn't have like Zoom and Iris and everything, you're always trying to get people in the same studio. Like, we just had our meeting, me trying to get everybody to schedule a time to do like, yeah, a podcast, and we're all in the same office, and that was a pain. Mm-hmm. Then I could imagine like trying to constantly schedule a new person just to come in, leave their work day to try and, like, do the podcast and kind of advertise their own company.
Sorry, go ahead.
No, I was going to have another question, but if you were going to bounce off of that.
No, I was going to say, yeah, definitely. I mean, there was some nights where, you know, it was myself, Dan Kimbrough, shout out to Dan. He did all of like the tech work behind the scenes. So it was us and Dan usually in this little stuffy podcast booth. And you know, myself and Nick and you know, some days we would have one interview where we'd be going down to the Think Center and it might take 20 minutes. And then there's other nights where, you know, we had back-to-back people because that's just how their schedule fell. So, like I said, it was definitely a learning experience. We connected with some awesome individuals. We got, you know, amazing stories. I really learned a lot about interviewing and how, you know, you might have one question and it could spark something that like you never thought it would have for this person. And then they start going down and talking about their family and their roots and, you know, their siblings. And then you get this really powerful podcast that you had really no intention of it being that way. And then you kind of go down this pathway. And I don't know, it's just really cool. It's an awesome experience.
I think it's always better when you're like interviewing and podcasting with someone. It's better to just try and gear it towards the person you're podcasting with rather than trying to pick your generic questions. I remember when I was doing the podcast with Joe and Sarah, I was trying to work with the frame, the con frames, or it's not a word. It's not a word. But the, I
The
guess,
structure.
the structure, the restrictions of kind of hitting these certain topics rather than trying to like gear it towards talking to the person I'm interviewing versus. Which is like, I hope this is a big difference. People listening will notice that there's not going to be the same questions I asked people before. Because a lot of the things that I also was really wanting to talk to you about is mainly kind of have to do with bouncing off of the podcast. One of the things I just realized talking is that I didn't know that Joe, our COO, who we've done a previous episode with, you met through the Books for Podcasts.
Oh yeah,
Hi.
so yeah, he was the director of Wilkes-Barre Connect at the time. So he actually was the one who reached out, which it's funny because my intern schedule, I always was working the days that like maybe Joe wasn't in the office because I don't believe he was working for the chamber at the time, but he was working within the office. So I would see him like passing by and he would always be like, "Hey, how are you?" But like I never actually talked to him. So it wasn't until after my internship when they reached out to me about, you know, just about the student ambassador program and everything. That's when Joe and I's, you know, relationship had started. And I, you know, then now I feel like I've known him for like 20 years, you know, just having conversations and stuff. But it is funny how like the world works that I had no idea. And that also connected me to our CEO, Nicole Farber, as well through that podcast. So, I mean, I always, you know, preach about how if you have an opportunity, no matter how like scary it is, just do it because you never know what the outcome of that opportunity could be. Going outside of your comfort zone and doing things for, you know, growth opportunities could lead you to so many open doors.
Yeah, like there's always a chance like to make a new connection that can lead you to somewhere else.
Yeah.
I guess this also kind of like makes it kind of clear a path on how you got to NX2, your interview with Nicole, that being how you met her. But then now I'm wondering like, well, did you get to NX2 through having interviewed Nicole or through having worked with Joe? Because now it's like not so clear. It seems almost it's like it's really interesting how small like for as big a state PA is, it's also not really a big state because everyone's
Yeah.
met each other at least once. So it kind
Yeah.
of makes you build a company that way by taking all these people who you've met and learned about and worked with before to make a new cohesive product. Like,
Yeah.
which one would you say led more to you joining NX2, knowing Joe already or having met Nicole?
So if you want to come down the Mariah rabbit hole, so I, like I said, I got the intern through the, you know, with the chamber and then the student ambassador program. And I actually, so within the student ambassador program, we had weekly meetings where we connected with business professionals, you know, that were connected to this conference that we were doing in November. And Nicole was one of the Avengers, you know, this group of Avengers, which were, you know, young professionals, the CEOs of different companies that came together, you know, this awesome group of individuals, and they helped market the conference. So the one week day, we were at King's College and we had the meeting and Nicole came. You know, she just talked about her business and all that and like how we can grow awareness for the conference and everything, and just also just learning about her company as well. So that was like my first encounter with Nicole. And then, like I said, after a couple of weeks, we realized, you know, myself and my co-host Nick, we were going to do this podcast. So it just so happened that my co-host Nick, who went to school for graphic design, had asked, like, through this encounter with Nicole, had contacted her for an internship opportunity. So Nick had gotten the internship opportunity. And just another layer of the onion, Nick and I also worked at the local trauma center down the road here, GWV. So we also worked together professionally as well. So it literally just so happened that they had an opportunity open for social media, which is where how I started at NX2. So Nick had literally asked me, oh my gosh, I think you should really apply. And I'm like, I don't know. Like, I have like 4 months left of school at this point. And I was like, I don't even know if they would, like offer it to me. So literally the exact day that I went in for an interview was the exact day that Nicole was coming on the podcast, just to talk about
That's
her
perfect
journey.
timing.
Yeah, so it was pretty wild. So like I had the interview that day and then I was like, okay, see you in like a couple hours. And then that evening was when she came on the podcast. So we were all in the little podcast booth and her videographer Emily, shout out Emily, she was taking fun videos and pictures of us. And that night was when she offered me the position. So yeah, like I
Did
said, you kind
she
of
do it on the podcast?
no, oh God, I would be like mortified.
That would be like a funny episode. That'd be like the climax of a movie about your life where.
Right? It's like, woo! No, but yeah, so it was great. So it was like so weird, like I said, how like saying yes to one thing, putting yourself outside of the comfort zone, getting to like, meet people and just forcing yourself to connect with people, and then you never know what happens. Like I said, yeah, the podcast episode, I was able to connect with her, interview her, and then that's how I got my job.
Well, your original position, it was just a social media assistant originally, and then you became the talent coordinator. How did that change like your day to day? Because they're not like based on title wise, I wouldn't really draw a connection between social media assistant and talent coordinator. By the way, you're shaking your head, I can see it seems like they're not at all that related.
No, so yeah, so I got the opportunity to kind of revamp our handbook, help in the hiring process, which brought you and Katie on. So, utilizing LinkedIn Learning and just kind of learning the ins and outs of, talent acquisition and how to do the interview process and everything. And also alongside with that, I'm also I direct the internship program here at NX2. So just understanding what goes into an internship program, what we wanted the students to do on a, a semester basis, and then going through that interviewing process as well. Everything in your life kind of leads up to where you are now, obviously. And I think that the podcast and interviewing people and just being able to read people, understanding their passions and what their focus is, where they want to see themselves has really helped me in those areas. Being able to, like I said, bring people in like yourself on a job interview and just seeing where you want to go. Because I know Joe had touched on it, his podcast about, just personal and professional growth and how, NX2 is really striving for us as individuals and young professionals to really get that personal and professional development. And, maybe this is where you want to be forever, or maybe this is something as a stepping stone for your next phase in life. But I think it's really awesome that, like I said, we really focus on that personal and professional growth. And for me, where I started at social media and kind of where I wanted to go in my next phase, which was talent coordinator, NX2 was able to get me there. And then, for the next phase of my life, it'll help me get to where I need to go as well.
So is it like so it seems almost as if you saw there was a need for this at NX2 that kind of lined up with where you wanted to be. So
Yeah.
did you kind of like create this position in NX2 because you saw like there was a need for it here that kind of saw our talent and then
Yeah.
also are furthering or like bettering our talent?
I definitely would say at the time there was a need for it. And like I said, we had a couple like transitions between just team members and all of that. And then, like I said, bringing on yourself and Katie, we needed somebody to create the, the job posting and get it out there and connect with those individuals, the prospects. And then, like I said, going through the interview process, wrapping it up and seeing like who would be the best fit, not only for the job and the day-to-day, but for our culture and the, the small community that we've created.
Thank you so much for like sharing your story and thank you for joining me today. And NX2 is incredibly lucky to have you, and I for one would not be here without you. So
Thank you.
thank you.
I gotta say, you're doing an excellent job on this podcast. I'm loving the ideas and just where you're taking this. I think it's a really awesome, just an opportunity for yourself. And I just think it's cool for the company being able to, showcase us and see us in a different light. So I just want to say thank you. You're doing an awesome job.
Thank you. I really do appreciate that. And
Absolutely.
that is all the time we have for today, and I thank everyone for listening, and bye.
Peace out, y'all.